In every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You find the fun, and snap! The job's a game. And every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake, a lark, a spree. It's very clear to see that a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down. The medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way.
So after you conceal everything, you want to put on foundation or BB cream. I decided to use BB cream on my sister because she does not have that many imperfections. And then I went in with another concealer for specifically under the eyes just to give a nice refreshed look because, you know, Mary Poppins did not have sleeping problems. And then I blended this in with my finger rather than a beauty blender because I like the way it turns out better. And then I patted her face in with some translucent setting powder just to make sure that everything stayed. After that, I bronzed up her face a little bit with some bronzer, but you want to make sure not to go too heavy on the bronzer and not really sculpt their face too much because you don't want to take away from the blush.
Stop the voiceover for a second, but for the main focus of the Mary Poppins makeup is the rosy cheeks and the like nice complexion. So we're not really going to be doing much else. I'm using my Naked Trio. It's okay, the music's fine. And I'm going to be using this blush.
Then I just created two perfectly circles on the apples of her cheeks with one blush. And then I went in with a different blush and kind of led it up a little bit toward her cheekbones, but not too much.
And I'm just putting a little bit on her nose with my finger.
Moving on to the eyeshadow, I took a neutral color and put that all over the base of her eye just to create a nice base for the eyeshadow look that we were going to do. Mary Poppins does not have any type of crazy eyeshadow. It's very neutral. So I took a darker brown shimmery color and put that in her crease and the outer corners of her eyes. And I took the brown color once again and packed it on, focusing on the outer corners just to give her eyes some depth so that they can appear larger. And then once I blended that color, not have any harsh lines, I added a gold shimmery color all over her lid and a white lighter champagne color on her brow bone. And that's all for the eyeshadow.
The last thing I did in regards to makeup was the infamous signature red lipstick. I lined her lips and created a base with my red NARS lipstick pen and then went in with a red lipstick.
We did the red bow tie with some ribbon that we found in our craft drawer, and she wore a white button-up with a large purse, trying to resemble Mary Poppins' large magical bag that she has throughout the movie. Then we used a red ribbon around her waist, a long navy blue skirt, some black flats, and an umbrella just for extra touch. So for Bert's makeup, I used my Makeup by Mandy 24 palette with a thick MAC brush, and we just added black eyeshadow all over his face and kind of spread it out with our fingers, trying to make it look like the dust from the chimney sweep, because Bert is a chimney sweeper in the movie.
Chimney, chim, chimney, chim, chim, cheree. A sweep is as lucky as lucky can.
This outfit is super easy to recreate. All you're gonna need is a black button-up, preferably long sleeve, but anything works. And we have a black plaid scarf with some red in there, and black skinny jeans, and the shoes can be any shoes, really. Chris chose Vans.
Both of these costumes were super easy to recreate and had very minimal makeup, and you probably have a lot of this stuff already at home. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you found it helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up and leave a comment down below. Thanks for so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next week.
For a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down. The
done.